Welcome to this short video on why and when to use vibration analysis. Vibration is measured for various reasons: earthquakes, bridges, manufacturing quality, structures, etc. A very common use for vibration is to diagnose faults in rotating machines without tearing down the machine. Vibration in a rotating machine is normal, but high vibration can be destructive. Determining the frequency of the vibration and finding recognized patterns can reveal the presence of mechanical faults. Condition-based maintenance relies on machine condition, rather than a calendar, to identify and plan repair actions. This improves uptime and asset life, decreases maintenance costs from unnecessary repairs, and eliminates energy waste. Why use vibration before other technologies? Because it is the best practice for when a mechanical fault needs action. Thermography is good, but it's often too late. Temperature increases at the later stages just before failure. Ultrasound is good, but is often too early. Bearings make noise very early, and often they just need to be lubricated. Vibration is best for diagnosing mechanical faults and tracking the severity from slight to extreme over 12 to 18 months or longer. What is the solution? Use the best practice technology for the expected failure mode. What is the difference between vibration monitoring, screening, and analysis? Vibration monitoring is performed to collect data from machines using sensors, wired, wireless, and with portable tools. Vibration screening is an effective way to screen a machine to determine if it's good enough to run or needs further testing. Trends of simple numbers and broadband alarms that look at all vibration sources quickly indicate potential problems. But just like blood pressure and pulse are easy to track, an increase could mean something is bad or nothing at all. Vibration analysis is an effective way to analyze frequency graphs to determine a fault using pattern recognition. But just like an EKG has a lot of information, it often takes a trained and experienced analyst to unlock the answers. Narrowband alarms look for patterns of mechanical faults and ignores noise from structures, resonances, and the process. There are different types of vibration sensors. How is vibration measured? There are three different ways. Number one, displacement is the distance that an object moves from a reference point. This is best measured with a proximity probe on girdle bearings, but this often requires extensive installation work. Displacement is best for measuring low frequencies. Number two, velocity is the distance an object moves over a given time. In the past, it was measured with a velocity probe, but the moving parts wear quickly and break. No longer is this common. Velocity is best for measuring the mid frequencies. This is the most common for most standard rotating machines. Number three, acceleration is the change in velocity over a given time, often measured with an accelerometer. No moving parts, stable over many years, which makes it the best sensor. Acceleration is best for measuring high frequencies. This is common for looking at early warning of roller bearings. Which method is best? Velocity covers the widest range of frequencies for most machines and best for diagnosing the forces of fatigue that cause wear and eventual failure. Solution? It is the most common to use an accelerometer and then quickly convert from acceleration to velocity. What is an industrial vibration sensor and how does a vibration sensor work? Industrial machines require a rugged sensor which is best found in the piezoelectric accelerometer. The piezo vibration sensor is made up of a crystal that is between a mass and the base. As the machine vibrates, the crystal is squeezed and emits electricity proportional to the mechanical force. A piezo vibration sensor provides high resolution, high frequency data needed to diagnose bearing faults. What new vibration sensor types are available? MEMS accelerometers have been available for years in cell phones and other devices. The MEMS vibration sensor is made up of a digital circuit that measures acceleration. Recent technology advances have dramatically improved the quality of the measured data. The MEMS vibration sensor provides good, low-frequency data needed to screen shaft-related faults. Reviewing the vibration results. When to wait, when to act, what to do. Many think that high vibration means that something needs to be fixed immediately, but that is often not the case. Just because the vibration is high doesn't mean that there's a fault. All machines have vibration, and vibration can come from many different sources. High vibration could be from background noise, the process itself, an adjacent machine, the structure, or resonance. If users overreact and replace bearings just because it seems to be the fault most times, they will be disappointed. The broadband alarms used in vibration screening provides a simple number which is easy to trend, but it combines all the vibration signals from all sources. It could be a fault, but it could also be something else. This means that further testing is needed. Go to the machine, look, listen, and feel. If vibration is high, use a vibration portable analyzer or wireless analysis sensor to better understand the specific fault. The FFT, or fast Fourier transformation, removes random noise by looking only at repetitive signals. Vibration analysts with training experience can analyze hundreds of different faults based on very defined patterns. The narrowband alarms used in vibration analysis provides notifications of specific frequencies that indicate faults, confirmed by reviewing the data, looking for prescribed patterns for imbalance, misalignment, looseness, and bearings. Just because the machine has a fault doesn't mean that the action is needed. Sometimes it's best to just wait and watch. If users overreact and repair the fault just because an early indication shows up, they'll be disappointed. Instead, track the fault and watch the severity until repair action is warranted. It could take 12 to 18 months or longer. What if vibration is high and no mechanical fault is found? Then further testing is needed. Call in a specialist with an analyzer. Be sure to watch the other short videos on when and how to use the 3563 and 3562 sensors.